Probably the project that is one of the most well-known projects is our project for the National Gallery extension in London, in a very important site, Trafalgar Square. It's known as the Sainsbury Wing. And that is very, very complex in terms of how we did it. It's a competition that we won. Very often, if you're good, you don't win a competition, but we miraculously did win the competition. And there are a lot of ways we can approach, talk about how we approached it. But essentially, on the outside, the facade is somewhat, well, it's very important to look at the context. And the main aspects of the context are it's in Trafalgar Square, so it's a building which is helping form the exterior square or place in central London. Probably it's the biggest square in London. Then also, it does connect with an important building, which is the National Gallery of Art, which is a symmetrical building, classical building of the 1830s. So we're doing two main things when we were designing that building from the standpoint of the front and from the standpoint of the outside. One was that it was to be a continuation of the existing building, although not a copy of it. And then the other was that it was to be a building that helped, that acknowledged its position on the piazza, on the square, and helped the enhance the quality of the square. And so essentially what we did when we analyzed the existing National Gallery building, it's a building that has a classical vocabulary and that its main aesthetic element is that of rhythm, that the vertical columns and pilasters on the building make for a kind of complex rhythm that's a little different in the front and then extends beyond and varies as it goes, but it's generally pretty consistent. So the rhythm of our building is such that we actually copied, which horrified modernists, we actually, on this one facade, not on the rest of the building, we copied the vocabulary, the elements of the 1830s building, but we made the pilasters not have an even rhythm, but a rhythm which was uneven and which inflected toward the building next to it. So therefore, it was a building separate from the other building by a space, but also inflecting toward the other building, so it's saying we are part of the elder building. We're not just an addition, we are a continuation of it. So this varied rhythm, which is sort of jazzy, jazzy, but sort of a jazz rhythm, as opposed to the rhythm of the of the old building, which was sort of a correct rhythm of maybe you'd find of a gavotte or a minuet. Then we had to have a very big entrance at the bottom to accommodate anticipated 4 million. I think it's more than 4 million a year now, whereas the other building was built originally for a few thousand gentlemen a year. And so it's like the old building, but it has this huge Zoom entrance in it, which is contradictory to the classical requirements, and which has this indirect rhythm. And then when you look at from the side, you see the side of the building along that narrow space between the new and the old building, and it is essentially a Mies van der Rohe modern building with lots of glass and steel construction. And then when you go in the back, it's different too. So it's a building that whose facades all accommodate context. And then when you go in, that's another whole story. But essentially, the outside was that. So the building was easily misunderstood. I think a lot of people did love it. We have copies of good quotes and negative quotes from the writers. And the negative quotes are wonderful. It's a piece of vulgar American blah blah and all that. And then there are other quotes that are very nice. But it is essentially a building where the pure modernist said, "Oh, it's not modern because it has adapted the classical elements." And then that's what the modernist said, then the classicist said, "Hey, it's not correctly historical because it has this jazzy rhythm instead of a correct classical rhythm." then the inside is another story, which is interesting. But it is so nice that the client liked it, and in general, the family of the donors who gave all the money, a lot of money, more or less went along with it. We had some problems with dealing with the client, involving some details, but in general, in the end, it turned out on the outside the way we wanted it, and it's a building I love, and it really does connect with us, which is mannerism. It doesn't find one ideology, it doesn't find a consistent system, and it does accommodate, because it's accommodating to all of these different kinds of symbolism, styles, and contextual requirements.